I'm going to do you a big favor this morning. Having had to reach out and develop lots of relationships in my life and in my business endeavors, and being a target for many other people's reach out, I've got a pretty good perspective on what works and how people really screw up in the networking and business relationship development process. So this morning, I will share how I see people screwing up the most so you don't do this anymore. Number one, you don't show up. Oh, sure, your body's at the event or chit-chatting with the person in front of you, but it's just a husk of a thing. Your spirit is void. Your energy is what introduces you. Just because you're quote-unquote doing business, it doesn't mean that you can't or shouldn't be energetic, joyful, and personable. In fact, making a great first impression requires it. It doesn't matter how talented you are or how well-connected or wealthy you are. Nobody likes a bore or a bummer dog. Positive energy is what attracts positive energy. Number two, you beat your chest to death. If you want the doors of opportunity to open or stay open, it's important that you always remain humble, grounded, and willing to learn and listen. Humility is admitting that you don't know something, that you need help, and that you are actually willing to listen. But first, be interested before you try to be interesting. And number three, you get all grabby. You think the game is grabbing business cards. None of that will matter when you call, if you ever do follow up, which most people don't, when they say, "Who?" You are a mile wide and an inch deep with your relationships, or better described as far distant acquaintances. Instead, you want to focus on cultivating the intense few instead of the lukewarm many in your relationships. Having a drawer full of business cards of names of people who you don't know, care about, or even remember you is of no value at all. The only objective to networking is to make meaningful and memorable connections. One where there is a person who is delighted to hear from you on the other end and eager to continue the relationship with you. Number four, you make BS promises. Nobody trusts a person who says they can do something that never happens. Tried and true business relationships manifest solely through action. If you agree to do something, then dagnabbit, do it. That is the best way to have trust be born in the relationship. Unfortunately, most people try to build relationships on the basis of promises. They measure their value through the things they say they can do as opposed to the things they actually and consistently deliver. Don't be the guy or gal full of hooey. And number five, you play the short game. Business and relationships take time. Some of the best opportunities take months or even years to nurture. Some of the best connections require giving a lot for a long time in order to create a mutually beneficial relationship. To build sound relationships, you can't expect bonds to be formed overnight or favors to be exchanged early in the getting to know and the trust building phase. Number six, you're a taker. You should always give more than you take. Deposit more than you withdraw. Keep your relationship accounts in the black and stacked. Remember this, it's only when you contribute more than you consume that you have a justifiable reason to even exist in someone's life. Every time you tap each relationship account, you should be depositing back twice as much. And if you're asked for a favor, that is your golden opportunity. Don't screw it up. Deliver, deliver fast, deliver above expectations, and you will enter into a whole other category in someone's head and heart when you do. Do be on their short list of doers. And number seven, you are a fair weather networker. You can't go dark or radio silent on someone for months and then reach out only to ask them for a favor. That is super lame, man. Don't do that. Relationships take time and investment, not once or a few times, but constantly and continually. You have to take time to check in, catch up, and show an interest in their lives, their goals, and what's going on with their aspirations. This is why I suggest that you focus on the intense few versus the lukewarm many. If I were to really cut to the chase here, no one cares about you or your business or your goals or your personal interests. They only care about their own. And until you are a value to them, their agenda, they won't even consider you or give you any time, energy, or attention. It all starts with you. You giving value first, often and more than they could ever reciprocate. Put another way, it doesn't matter how valuable you think you are until you are a value to others. So go out there today and be a value.